So first of all, how are you feeling today? Okay. Two cities in 2 days?
Okay.
Two cities in 2 days? What do you say?
Yeah, two cities in 2 days. Hustle. I mean, you gotta, first of all, if you ain't gonna feel too bad, you gotta like do a little workout here and there, keep yourself right, you know? Man, I'm thinking about another year and a half, I'll be 60.
Wow.
So then, I don't feel 60. I think I gotta make sure my mom got the birth certificate right. I don't feel a year and a half from 60, but they say I'm there, so I'm good.
Wow.
Let me say this though. Let me say it's good to see you. Look at the energy. Look at the excitement. Look at the really split down the middle. Who believe people think or who they want to win or whatever the case is. I mean, this is what boxing to me is what I came up watching.
Now,
whether it's the 80s, 90s.
I know you want to see the best against the best. You've always told me that going back 15 years. Yesterday on stage, Leonard said that if it was up to Ryan's promoters, that wouldn't happen. What's your response to that?
They're in the situation where if it's a great place, you can see it a couple more times. And not necessarily need it. There's plenty of time.
Delusional.
Doesn't need to be.
Not keeping it real with the fans. Matter of fact, I don't even know why he was here. You know what I mean? With reason and business, he got to be here. I do know why, but I mean, on the other end, but in the same token, you know, just want to show that somehow that side has a title, still some way involved or evolving into something that they're going to, I don't, you know, it just, when I heard that, I thought about it, and then I said, look, you got to get attention somewhere. But at the end of the day, it don't mean nothing.
I saw you and Oscar were laughing. Now, you know Ryan, you followed him from day one. This is a mega fight. It's not an easy fight for either guy. How do you see it unfolding right now?
I see a style as I watch Marvin Hagler and Tommy Hearns. The message out of that fight is, you know what happened. Tommy Hearns is a taller, leaner fighter. If he don't be on the ropes and he fight him in the middle and he keeps him to the point where he can go ahead and hit and use his height, arm reach. To me, both guys can look at one fight. And this will tell you where I'm at, how this fight is spit down the middle, 50-50. Each fighter can look down at the Hagler and Tommy Hearns fight. Each fighter, Tank and Ryan. And see what Hagler was doing, coming forward, being relentless. And Tommy Hearns couldn't keep him off him and back Tommy up on the ropes. So the ropes will not be Ryan Garcia's friend in that style. And Marvin Hagler will not be the friend or the middle of the ring will not be the friend of Marvin Hagler. So both fighters have to be disciplined to be able to one round, two rounds, to whenever it ends, have to keep that in mind. The styles make the fights. Again, Marvin Hagler and Tommy Hearns is lessons in both of those fights. No matter who you like.
Really quick, Oscar. So, Bhop the legend, the icon. Both you guys are Hall of Famers. He just told me Tank and Ryan is like Hagler Hearns. What do you think?
But the difference is what? Both fighters, Tank comes forward, relentless. Ryan, ropes is not his friend. He need distance. He need to get his linky body in the motion where he can have the extension of those punches. Both fighters can look at that fight and learn with their weakness or their strength.
I actually just said that it could be Hagler Hearns all over again. So he described it perfectly.
Come on, man. And we didn't talk about this morning. We ate.
Well, you know, boxing. Last thing. So Calvin Ford told me he's a huge fan of yours. Does it happen to you where you're on the other side and the other side, like they look up to you? Is that normal right now? Because everybody loves Bhop.
Well, I think we can disagree to agree. But at the end of the day, I think my credibility and I think 28 years of being in the sweet science, that's how long my career lasts. I think even my enemies got to pay homage. They might not do it to me in my face, but in this case, this guy is a Muslim. He respects me. I respect him. And you heard the good words yesterday. And I want to say likewise. Like I said it to him personally, I said it to him media way.
Thank you so much, Bhop.
Respect.
Always great. Thank you
reporting.
So much for the insight. Reporting.
So, Bhop, today's energy was on a different level than yesterday, guys.
Very, very.
Why?
Very. The fighters, the attitude, what they bring to the table. I could have said one word, credibility. Nobody has to fabricate how big and important this fight is. It is what it is. This fight really don't need any hype. But you got to go through what we go through to promote it. And they got to deliver what we talked about or promoted about. Now, it's different opinions. That makes the fun part. Somebody got to be wrong, and somebody will be right.
Okay, so let me ask all three of you guys. You have to score this, the press conference, like a fight, a 10-8 round, 10-9, 10-10. How would you score it today? Bhop?
10-9.
For who?
Ryan.
Chucky?
I'm going to say 10-8.
For Tate?
Why you introduce me to this person?
He's playing.
What's good?
What do you say?
Man, I'm gonna say they're even, man. You know what I'm saying? Ryan talked a little good stuff today, but man, we ain't in no talking contest.
No, now listen, I really meant everything I said.
No, but it's a sport, and then we want people to tune in, and everybody has their opinion. That's why we watch, because we don't know what's gonna happen.
But that what makes this fight so exciting, and I know you want to say something real quick, but I got to come off that, because this fight is really a 50-50 fight. I'm not even promoting this shit like that. I'm telling you, I am promoting it, but I'm not promoting it just that you do this interview, because I'm telling truth talk from a fan, because obviously I put my 30 years in the game, Hall of Famer, all that stuff is there. But as a fan, it's always with being me, because this is what I love. This is what I come up with 9 years old in the amateurs, and seeing both fighters undefeated, young, believe they the best in that division, saying, I'm going to give up this concession to make that happen. Not that one. No, let's try to work. No, I want it. I don't want them to come back with nothing else. That was Ryan. You heard that up on stage. Ryan gave up as partner and owner of Golden Boy. Ryan gave up some concessions I don't believe I would have done it. That's how bad he wanted this one. And he said, I don't want a tune-up.
He couldn't afford.
He could. No. I don't want a tune-up because I want to go right to the dance. I don't want to get hurt. I don't want to get cut. I don't even want to make anything to a point or excuse for what I need to do or what I want, or have anybody say, oh, something had happened. I don't want to get injured, but I'm going to be in the gym. I'm going to spar hard. I'm going to do what I got to do. And then when that time comes, I'm going to let them have those things that they thought I was going to say no to. You ever been in a situation?
What about my man?
You ever been through a situation somebody say, hey, man, well, it throws a number at you. Shit, I got it. That's street stuff. See, I'm talking street now.
Hey, yeah, but what about when you take a fighter that take an undefeated world champion and crush him for your tune of fight?
I mean, it happens. It's a paycheck. But this here is different. You got two fighters that have experience with each other by growing up as youngies and the amateurs. And then you know they sparred a couple times. They say, oh, no, that's the amateurs. But at least I got a feel for you. If I was in high school with you and I chucked you in high school, now all of a sudden we out of college and we get a little money, now you think you're the man. That's not really you for real. You know what it is?
In what way? In any jump, in any sparring session?
I ain't say that.
Oh, okay.
And he damn sure ain't do that to Ryan.
Oh, okay.
But they know each other. That's why they're so confident that they can do what they can do to each other, because they come up from the ranks where, oh, you and any, you represent that city, that country, that state. Y'all meet up and meet at the top of their level. So they know each other. It's no strangers. Have they been in the ring with each other?
Chad, yeah. You a historian.
Yeah, hold up.
How many world titles you win?
Have they been in the ring? Yes, they've been in the ring with each other.
How many world titles you win, Chad?
About 10.
So you know sparring and getting in there for a fight is two different things, right? You can be in the sparring.
Oh, absolutely.
So we can't.
For both of them. I'm just trying to tell you the feel. Okay. I'm just trying to tell you the feel. And one thing about practice hurt too.
Right.
Now, hold on, let me tell you something. See, I never practiced even in sparring.
Yeah.
Maybe that's the Philly thing, right? Philly wars, and then when they get ready for a fight, they're all beat up.
Right.
That's been our stigma, right? It changed in the last 20 years. But we are, right, headgear and all that, and you can stop enemy around, say, oh, wait a minute, somebody get hurt. Yeah, you got those luxuries, right? But listen, both of these fighters have something that could be kryptonite or can be the opposite. It could be to their detriment. They cannot make a mistake and think they won't pay for it.
Right.
They know each other, man. That's just like, no, you step to him, you know he's coming right. You gotta step to him right. And so, and some dudes, some people in the street, you know, you can't just come up to him, man. And you said, you can't do that
they,
here.
They met each other. They didn't know each other April 22nd. They met each other April 22nd. After April 23rd, when I look at you, I'm gonna say, Bhop, now they know each other.
I think it'll be more than that.
I don't know. Remember, I'm gonna come up to you. I'm gonna find you. I don't care where
after
we at.
Or before?
After the fight. After the fight, I'm gonna come find you. April 22nd or 23rd, I'm gonna come find you in Las Vegas and tell you, champ, now they know each other.
I believe you're going to say thing, man. What you knew, I didn't know.
Okay, we're going to see. It's recorded. Now, we're going to see what we say. Now,
listen to what I'm saying. Listen to what I'm saying. One thing about Tank, his career won't end, you know what I mean, that night. He just got to restart, like great ones do. When he restart, then he'll fix those little things that cost him that next stage to greatness. See, they at the door, but nobody just gonna open it. They gotta kick it in. So I'm gonna wait for
tell
that.
Ryan Garcia, I know you watching this interview. Man, you can take the listen. L off a lover. Listen. It's over.
Listen.
You can and take, I'm done after
listen,
that.
Listen, you can take that Z, you can take that O. And keep it that way. And that way, we gonna look for each other come fight night. See, that's what this boxing is about.
Right.
Two guys, well respected. I respect that brother, he respects me.
Right,
but I'm telling you, he's gonna be wrong. And he will tell you when I leave, he's gonna be right.
All right, B.I., we gotta go visit the marathon. Where can we come visit the marathon, Chucky? What's a good time?
Whenever.
All right. We'll come down, let us know. Stay tuned, Nelly Sec Back Report. What's your Instagram, by the way?
Bones.
Where are you at?
Big Ram 419.
Stay tuned. Ellie Sec Back Report. I'm Ellie Sec Back. Ellie Sec Back Reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sec Back Reporting. ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sec Back Reporting.